Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In our previous videos, we discussed CorpVault users, user groups and roles. In this video, we will discuss domains and organizations. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. A domain controller is a server that manages network security and user credentials. External users or groups from Microsoft's Active Directory or IBM's Domino Directory service can be associated with CorpVault user groups. Associated external group members can log into the CorpVault console using their external credentials. In the CorpVault browser, expand Security. Click on Domains and Organizations. At the moment, we do not have any associated domains. Right-click on Domains and Organizations. Hover over Add New Domain. Domains are external domains that you can register with a CorpVault computer. CorpVault supports these types of domain controllers, and they are Microsoft Active Directory, Apple Open Directory or Apple Directory Service, Oracle Directory, Open LDAP, etc. You can register domain controllers in the command center as well, so that users can log on to the command center with their domain credentials. Please note, each domain controller must have a unique name. You cannot register duplicate domain controllers with the CorpVault. Let's start with Active Directory, also called AD. You can add an Active Directory domain, so that users can log on to the CorpVault environment, with their Active Directory credentials. An AD user can log on with either a user ID and password, or an email address and password. You can apply security associations to the AD users to control the access they have in the CorpVault environment. Add New Domain Controller window. Use this window to add or edit an Active Directory domain controller. General tab. NetBIOS name is the NetBIOS name of the domain. Domain name is the fully qualified domain name. If Use Secure LDAP is enabled, the domain name is the name of the domain controller. User account. Click Edit to enter the user account information for the domain. If your CorpVault host is a member of the domain controller, you can enter local system account and leave the password blank instead of a domain user account. If you are using a domain user account, type in the domain user credentials. In this case, we are trying to use administrator account, who is domain admin, as well as domain user. Let us see if we can use this account. Resource domain. If you have an Active Directory resource domain, you can register it with the CorpVault, so that users in the admin domain can access the resources in the resource domain. The admin domain contains the user credentials for all users. The resource domain includes the resources or applications that can be accessed by each user in the admin domain. Enable SSO. Single sign-on can be enabled to allow external users already logged into the domain to access the CorpVault console without re-entering their password. This option automatically logs users on to the CorpVault console and web console. Important to note is, associated external groups can be used as recipients for CorpVault console alerts and reports. In order to receive an alert or report, the external user must have logged into the CorpVault console at least once in order for the system to obtain the SMTP mail address of the user. Use Secure LDAP. Enable the Secure Lightweight Directory Access Protocol for additional network security with the external domain. Please note, this can only be enabled when the external domain is configured to use the Secure LDAP. If this protocol is enabled from the CommCell console, but not configured from the external domain, the feature is not enabled. Disable the use of this controller. If selected, this domain controller is disabled from use. Network proxy settings. Access the domain controller through. Select this option to use a client computer as a proxy to connect to a remote Active Directory server. Client name lists the client computers that you can use to access the server. You can add more than one proxy. Use these options to manage the entries. SMTP addresses. In the text box, enter an SMTP address. Use the Discover option to identify the users. The SMTP address identifies the users, who must be authenticated by using SAML. Description. Use this field to enter a description about the entity. This description can include information about the entity's content, ticket number, and so on. Additional settings tab. Use this window to set additional settings, in other words, registry keys. Additional settings are advanced options that can be used to perform troubleshooting and other environment-specific configurations. Once done, click OK to add the new domain controller. We received error. The credentials you have entered could not be verified. Let's remove the domain and just give the username and check. We received the same error. Let's give proxy and check. We did not get the error. It accepted the credentials, and domain is added successfully. Let's validate the credentials and check. We received the same error. This means, we cannot use the administrator account. We can use another domain user account and check. We have created another account who is domain admin. Consider using a service account instead of an employee account to prevent disruptions if the employee account is disabled. If you are using a domain user account, the account must have at least read access to the domain. We will remove the proxy access and then validate. Successfully verified the connectivity with domain controller using the supplied user account. Once done, click OK. The domain is now successfully added to the CommCell. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will discuss adding external user and group. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.